The BRSCC BMW Compact Cup is brought to you by Nankang Tyres and Gas Shops.
Welcome to the next round in the Nankang Tyres BMW Compact Cup. Before the racing gets underway, we caught up with Championship Coordinator Greg Graham for his thoughts at the midway point of the season.
Greg, we're six races into the Championship and it's really good fun to watch. Close racing at the front. Talk us through how it is from a coordinator's point of view.
Frenetic most of the time, to be perfectly honest with you. It's good fun. It's just as good fun managing it. I was going to say as driving in it, that's not quite the case, but it's rewarding when you see 33 cars out halfway through the season. The numbers are growing as well. We've got new guys. We've got a chap from Milan who's built his car in Milan and drove over to race this weekend, Alessandro Albano. We've got new people joining us next month. We've got three new drivers this weekend. It's fantastic. It's going from strength to strength.
It absolutely is, and here is how the championship standings look coming into this weekend. Just 15 points separate Daly and Hunter at the top of the table. Ian Jones and Matt Parks are there or thereabouts, whilst Paul Hinson and David May are fighting over fifth. Here's how the grid lines up then for race number one of the day. Stephen Daly and Ian Jones on the front row, with Hunter and Huntley on the second row. Paul Hinson and David May together on row three, as they are in the championship. Then it's Sam Carrington Yates and Mark Skeets, Keith Towers and Wayne Flint, with Andrew Prince and Matt Flowers on the sixth row. Row 7 for Gordon McMillan and Tom Langford. Row 8, Craig Jameson and Alan Caulfield, with Tim Scott Andrews and Simon Welch on the ninth row. Next up are Martin Gadsby and Mike Doble to round out the top 20. Then Liam McGill and Mikey Doble ahead of Aaron Morgan and Jim Barrett. Jonathan Atkinson and Phil Adcock are next. Then Phil Sharp and Nick Edmund. Andrew Woodbine and Alessandro Albano, the man from Milan, round out the top 30. Colin Way, Tom Griffiths and Matt Parks. Now, Griffiths and Parks both had issues in qualifying. Griffiths didn't set a time. Parks was excluded. They both should be up towards the top 10. As the lights go out, we are away and racing for the first time here at the ultra high speed Castle Combe circuit. And already it's getting quite congested in the middle of the top 10. On board with David May. To our right was Owen Hunter. To our left was Ben Huntley. There's already a bit of trim dangling off the back of Owen Hunter's car. Before the race lead, they are side by side on the rush up towards Quarry Corner for the first time. On the inside line is Stephen Daly. On the outside is Ian Jones. Can Ian go right around the outside? He's going to try it, but the grip is on the inside, surely. And Daly will go through on board with Tom Langford, and that is a very close moment as Mark Skeets loses control right in front of most of the pack, spins back into the middle of the road, and miraculously is missed by everybody. So at the front of the field, whoops, that's Ben Huntley across the grass from fourth position. He rejoins, still in fourth place, just ahead of Paul Hinson. But right at the front of the field, it is the top three cars in the championship, who are top three in the race, but in a slightly different order. It is the championship leader, Stephen Daly, in front, but Ian Jones, third in the points and 8 points behind Owen Hunter, is ahead of Owen at this early stage of the race. On board with Simon Welch a bit further back. He's running in amongst the ever-exciting midfield squabbles that are going on throughout the field. But at the head of the field, the top three starting to break away. Huntley fourth, Hinson fifth, David May sixth, and then everyone else following in behind. Now, with the high-speed nature of this Castle Combe circuit, it can be difficult sometimes to make a break at the front of the field and pull away from everybody else. So it could well be that we see those top three cars continue to run closely together. However, this will help Stephen Daly because they're side-by-side behind him. Now, Ian Jones ran wide at the final corner, lost himself momentum, and Owen Hunter was straight up the inside. They're still side-by-side, though, as they go up towards Avon Rise for the second time of asking. But on the inside line, you'd imagine that Owen Hunter should be able to go through, and indeed he does. He makes the move stick before they hit the brakes at the top of the hill. So Daly leads the way. Hunter now into that second place, 15 points behind Stephen Daly going into this weekend is Owen Hunter. That is catchable, but he needs to start doing something about it now, really. He could do with beating Stephen Daly in at least one, preferably both of the races this weekend at Castle Combe, to start to close down that championship advantage. The rest of them filing through there. Sam Carrington Yates in the number 17 car. further back, the battle's as intense as ever. On board again with Simon Welch, and someone on the, that's a strange place to be on the grass, on the inside at Hammerdown. I've not seen a car off there before, whoops, and that was Andrew Prince, wasn't it, the number 29 car, who had a really good qualifying in the 11th place on the grid, but the race not quite going to plan. It's definitely started to go to plan though for Owen Hunter, because he is closing in on the race leader, Stephen Daly. The lead has definitely come down. It's only about a car length between them now. So Owen Hunter on the attack, looking to the inside of the KC Motorsport car, driven by the reigning champion, Stephen Daly. And Owen Hunter having a real career season this week, this year. He is by far the most competitive he's ever been as far as race wins are concerned, and the championship situation as well. And Owen Hunter really does want to get that first title in the championship. Back on board with David May, running down in the inner sixth position in behind Paul Hinson, as the leaders overlap slightly going in towards Quarry. But on the outside line, Hunter was never quite likely to go through there. What about the switchback on the exit though? Remember, 12 months ago, Stephen Daly and James Gornall engaging a very similar tussle to this. It did unfortunately end in contact though, in the end. Penalties were applied, and that would have a big say in the way the championship was concluded last year. This year, are we going to see them keeping a bit cleaner with Owen Hunter now part of the mix? Well, let's wait and see. Down towards Tower Corner they go. This is one of the better overtaking opportunities on the circuit, and Stephen Daly knows it, so he defends the inside line. Owen Hunter locks up the brakes on the outside line and very nearly opened the door for Ian Hunter to come through, for Ian Jones to come through. So that nearly went wrong for Owen. This is all getting rather congested though, and Owen is now stuck in the middle of the three. He's trying to attack for the lead, but also conscious of the fact that if he goes for a move that doesn't work, he will lose second place to Ian Jones. They've got a decent gap over Ben Huntley behind though, so it looks like it's going to be these three who will decide the race as we tick our way towards halfway race distance. As ever, just 15 minutes of racing in the BMW Compact Cup. The races always seem too short, don't they? The track was a bit too narrow there for Ian Jones, is liking. He ran a bit wide coming out of camp corner. That again just costs him a bit of speed up the hill, allows Owen Hunter to pull away and therefore focus all of his attention for the time being on attacking for the race lead in towards Quarry. Stephen Daly though takes the middle of the road under braking there, which is sort of the natural racing line anyway. Hunter though carries that speed on the exit of the corner and almost gets himself alongside. In fact, he might be alongside on the inside line down towards the S's. No, can't quite get there. Daly just chops his nose off, gets to the inside to defend. But this is all getting a little bit frustrating for Owen Hunter, I think. He can tell he's quicker. He just can't quite prise the door open. Back down towards Tower. There's another chance to overtake here, maybe. There's a gap on the inside, is there? No, Daly gets over to defend again. Hunter goes to the outside. Back to the inside again. Who's latest on the brakes? It's Daly. Is he too late on the brakes? No, he gets to the apex in time, and still Owen Hunter is frustrated in his efforts to get through and into the race lead here. It's Daly hanging on, and all of this dicing, if you look in the background, you can see that Ben Huntley in fourth place is now starting to inch closer towards them, and he's bringing friends as well, so that will add to the sense of urgency here for Owen Hunter to get this move done and try and escape up the road. Camp corner, the final turn here at Castle Combe, is not really an overtaking opportunity. Instead, focus on getting that good exit from the corner that he's been getting so far this race, but Daly was no slouch out of there either. A few of them kick up the dirt. You can see the little bit of damage on the front end of Owen Hunter's car. That's not been sustained in this race. That was actually sustained in a testing crash on Friday when he went off into the tyre wall, and the team worked wonders to get the car fixed in time for qualifying this morning in the pair of races. Clearly running really well. On board with Keith Towers. Lots of battling going on in front of us. We're on the inside of the 55 car of Wayne Flint, who turned into the apex. Keith had to back out of it. Keith Towers seventh in the points coming into this weekend, so he's having a really good season. And he's not that far away from the top five. Leaders back out of the S's and away through Westway and Hammerdown. And still, Stephen Daly appears to have the measure of Owen Hunter for the time being. Owen is a little bit further back actually now than he has been for a few laps, although Daly just drifts a bit wide there, going down through Tower Corner. May potentially cost him a bit of speed on the exit, but he didn't seem to desperately. Owen Hunter's still not really as close as he has been on previous laps, so is this team of Daly starting to warm to the task? Speaking of being warm, it is very hot here today at Castle Combe, so it's possible that a few of the drivers have maybe started off with slightly lower tyre pressures than they normally would have done, in the hope that the tyres therefore won't go off as much in the heat, and so that might explain why maybe Stephen Daly struggled early on, but he's now starting to come good as the tyres come under pressure. Back with David May here, sixth position still for the number 93 car. David May sixth in the championship, and on 242 points coming into this weekend. He's 19 points away from the top five, Paul Hinton being his target, but he's 50 in the championship coming into these rounds, at the midway point of the season as well. So this is the time of the year where we really do start to look at championship standings and whatnot. So we try to figure out who the favourites are, and as we sort of expected at the start of the year, it's these three who have become the most serious championship contenders, the three at the front of the road right now. Stephen Daly, Owen Hunter and Ian Jones, but David May, Paul Hinton, they've all had standout years as well to be on the fringes of the top five. There is David May, he's now caught Paul Hinton. Can he do anything about finding a way through into the top five? He's had a couple of top fives this year. So David, in fact, got his first top fives of the year at the start of the season. Really has come on strong since 2017. The winter testing, no doubt, and a bit of winter fettling of the car has helped David May to find a little bit more performance this year. He's in behind Paul Hinton as they race down toward the end of another lap. We're into the second half of the race now. And Stephen Daly just seems to be managing this fairly reasonable gap over the three behind. Seen this a few times this year, haven't we? When Stephen Daly gets out in front and is able to get into a bit of a rhythm, he's very difficult to beat. It's something you probably learned from seeing James Gordon do it to him so many times over the last couple of seasons. That's something that the 2016 champion was always so strong at, getting out in front, getting his head down, putting in qualifying laps. Only really when someone like Stephen, for example, was able to mess with him, force him to defend and sort of have a go at getting past, that's when maybe the gaps were a bit closer. But it looks as though Owen Hunter may have to settle for second place, unless he's just having a bit of a breather here, letting the tyres have a breather mid-race and getting ready to set up for another challenge later, because he does look like he's closing again now slightly. Down through the tyre again, Daly takes that slightly wider line in, which looks to be opening the door on the way into the corner, but then it means that he carries a bit more speed out of the turn in theory. Hunter is definitely closer than he's been for a couple of laps now. Heads out of the Bobby's chicane, down towards the camp corner, the final corner of the track, and yet Hunter's back with Daly now, there's no doubt about it. Flinging into the right-hander, that's a tight line taken by all three of them this time around, though Ian Jones still hanging on just about. They're already, though, starting to catch the tail end of the field. Colin Way is going to be the first driver to hopefully get out of the way and allow the leaders through, but they could catch him up towards Quarry Corner. This could be an interesting situation. Stephen Daly on the brakes. Oh yes, look at that, Andrew Way. Well, he had nowhere to go really there. Stephen Daly just arrived on the scene so quickly, but look at the momentum that's cost him. Owen Hunter is right there with him now, and that was an absolute gift for the man in second place, because he was inching towards Stephen Daly, but he wasn't really close enough to force the leader to defend. That is certainly not the case now. Stephen Daly will be having to drive through his mirrors to try and withstand the pressure from Owen Hunter, but we saw that coming. They were always going to catch Andrew Way up at Quarry Corner, and it's a tricky enough part of the circuit when you're on your own, let alone when you're battling for position and you've got a back marker in the way. But Owen Hunter does not want to let this opportunity pass him by. He's all over Stephen Daly as they go down towards Tower Corner, but of course it's also brought Ian Jones back into the equation. Down towards Bobby's, Daly flicks it into the right, through the left. Hunter took a bit of a quicker line through there, though I think he's in the slipstream down towards the final corner. He could possibly draw alongside here, and Stephen Daly will have to defend the inside line, which he does. Owen Hunter will therefore have to go to the outside, surely. Well, he in the end decides that it wasn't really worth taking the risk there through the final turn. So instead he tries to concentrate on corner exit speed, gets back in the slipstream. Now we're heading towards Quarry, the best overtaking opportunity on the circuit. Not sure Hunter's quite close enough. On board with David May meanwhile, and in front of us we've got Paul Hinson battling away with Ben Huntley. I think that this group also got caught out by the back marker, and so that's congested these three cars as well. Leaders back up towards Quarry. Ian Jones now starts to go on the attack, as Stephen Daly's a bit wayward through the right hander. Had Owen Hunter been a car length or so closer, he might have got on the inside. He couldn't be much closer now though, as they go back down towards the S's once again. But he's starting to run out of time, only a handful of minutes left on the clock. Owen Hunter, can he do this? Can he find a way through and snatch the race lead away from Stephen Daly? Or is Daly going to be able to hang on for another race victory? Down towards Tower they go. Hunter weaving this way and that. There's a gap on the inside almost, but Daly just manages to get over to defend. Stephen Daly, let's not forget, has had four wins thus far in 2018. Owen Hunter, just the one last time out at Cadwell Park. Sorry, two, beg your pardon, last time out at Cadwell Park. He was a double race winner, of course, at Cadwell, was Owen Hunter. and he really wants to try and build on that momentum now as we head down towards the final turn. He's almost pushing Stephen Daly down the camp straight in towards the final corner, and that might just force Daly into the mistake. So the thinking goes for Owen Hunter, but it's not something that happens that often that Stephen Daly makes a mistake, but he's driving under such intense pressure here. One false move, and it doesn't have to be a big mistake, just a fraction late on the brakes, a fraction sideways on the power, and Owen Hunter will be through into the race lead, and surely that would be a lead that he would not relinquish easily. Lock up there for Daly. Is that mistake that Owen Hunter was waiting for? No, Daly still gets into the corner. There's almost contact. Maybe there was a bit of paint trading between the two of them as Daly really slowed it down mid-corner. Hunter is weaving this way and that, just can't quite find a way ahead. Down towards the S is fantastic racing there, this from the Nankang Tyres BMW Compact Cup, as it always is, and they've outdone themselves the last few races. Cadwell Park produced a set of thrillers, and Castle Combe, we always imagine the high-speed, slipstreaming nature of this circuit, we'd get more great racing, and we're being treated to that already here in race one. Down towards Tower, onto the brakes. Daly just about hanging on to the race lead, but Owen Hunter is an ever-present threat in his mirrors, and it will not take much for Owen Hunter to find that gap and slip through. Back out of Bobby's, running out of time though, probably only one more lap to go I think after this one. Look at all this going on further back. Gordon McMillan, that is, the red and black car, leading this next train of cars. Liam McGill we've got in there too, and look at Matt Parks. Matt Parks there at the back of that quartet of cars, started 33rd on the grid, and he's not a million miles away from the top 10. A remarkable drive from him. Leaders though see the last lap board, they cross the start finish line for the final time and go on to their final lap around the Castle Combe circuit, and Stephen Daly just looks as though he's built up a bit of a margin now over the two behind, but we've thought this on a few occasions during this race, and then a couple of corners later Owen Hunter is right back with him. Owen won't give in, that's for sure. He desperately wants to get this race victory. Ian Jones is on the grass and kicking bits of bodywork and debris and dust up into the air. Still running in third place, is he? Sort of just hoping that the top two in front of him come together. Bit of a moment there for Daly, a bit sideways coming out of the S. But every time the mistake comes, it's at a point where Owen Hunter is a little bit too far back to capitalise. Whenever Owen is latched right onto the rear bumper of the leading car, that seems to be where Stephen Daly is driving faultlessly without making any mistakes. Down in towards Tower, there's another mistake there though. That was definitely a bit too wayward on the way into the corner, so Hunter will close back in, but that was the last genuine overtaking opportunity on the circuit. We'll weave our way now through the Bobby chicane for the final time. There is one more corner to go, and it's only the bravest of the brave who will try and overtake down into this corner. Neither of these drivers lack commitment though. Stephen Daly will know this. He'll have to surely be as late on the brakes as he can into the final corner, which he is, and barring a mistake on the exit, I think that Stephen Daly is going to come through to take another race victory. But that was one of the hardest fought of the year. Owen Hunter is second, Ian Jones comes home in third place, some more solid points for him. Fourth place then for Ben Huntley, fifth was Paul Hinson, sixth David May, seventh for Sam Carrington-Yates, eighth Tom Langford, ninth Keith Towers, and Gordon McMillan rounds out the top 10. Owen Hunter gets the bonus point for the fastest lap, by the way. Liam McGill 11th, Matt Parks 33rd to 12th at the end of the race, 21 positions gained. Tom Griffiths there, also we mentioned, started from the back. He gained 16 places to work his way up the order as well. I think I'm right in saying, got most of the cars to the finish. We lost, unfortunately, Alessandro Albano and Phil Adcock as well, but they were the only two retirements from what was a fantastic opening race of the weekend.
Stephen, congratulations on your win. Tough racing out there today.
Oh yeah, it's never easy. It's never easy, especially with Owen, Ian and Matt Parks, but unfortunately Matt Parks was sent to the back of the grid there, so that would have been a lot more interesting with Matt Parks in the mix. What can I say? Another win. I mean, we're over the moon with it. We really are. The car's performing well, but the competition's very, very tight now. And it's getting to the point where, you know what, these guys are here and the main business. So, I mean, we'll see how the next race goes and we'll take it from there.
Owen, congratulations on second place. You were putting a lot of pressure on Steve there. Can you do more for the second race, do you think?
I hope so. We had the car nailed then. Qualifying I wasn't too happy with, but I mean, after the crash we had on Friday, I couldn't really expect too much more. I just want to say a massive thank you to XDR Motors, Raw Motorsport, Trade Price Cars, Arthur Mays Westbury, and particularly Stephen Brown for the setup. That was superb then.